240 miles above the Earth. Astronauts aboard the Mir space station brace themselves for catastrophe. Seconds later, they feel a jolt as the Mir collides with a 7-ton unmanned cargo ship.
A couple of seconds went by and I thought, well, it hasn't broken yet. And then my ears started to pop. And then the siren goes off.
The pop and the siren mean the impact has punctured the station. Fole soon notices a hissing sound too. The pressurized air he relies on to breathe is leaking out into space.
And I think, oh, maybe this is it. You know, this is where I'm going to die.
The astronaut's only hope is to locate the leak in the Mir's vast and confusing frame. They have less than 30 minutes to seal the hole or risk a terrible death.
I'm feeling the heat of my body leave me and go out the window, and literally to space. I suddenly think, oh, this is a cold, hard, dangerous, uncaring universe. And the only people who are going to help us right now are us, no one else.
Sibliev radios Moscow to share the bad news. Controllers on the ground order him to stay on the line to report the falling pressure. Lazutkin works feverishly to seal off the part of the station that he suspects has the leak. Fole quickly joins in with the effort. The two astronauts grab a nearby hatch and press it closed to seal off the damaged part of the Mir.
They just sucked in. At that point, I waited to see if my ears were going to stop popping. And they seemed to stop popping. I thought, oh, I guess we've stopped most of the leak.